What's up guys, Pomzo87 here with my first ever career mode video. And for this season we'll be driving in the Red Bull racing car alongside Sebastian Vettel, and we'll be doing a short season, 7 races. So let's go out to the track for the first race in Melbourne. I should definitely advise you guys to keep watching right to the very end of the video, because there's a very exciting race coming up. That's my first race of the season. But now we're going to the track. The weather for the whole weekend is bright and sunny, so no chance of rain interfering or anything like that. And we'll now jump straight into Q2, as I passed through Q1 of that in instant. It's my first Q2 run, and it's not the most spectacular runs actually. Bit mediocre as it goes slightly too wide at the penultimate corner, and we probably could have taken the last corner a bit more aggressively. But as we open the DRS to go onto the main straight, and we cross the line to set a time that is nearly 2 seconds slower than Rosberg's fastest time, so we definitely need to improve to get through to Q3. But unfortunately, in my final Q2 run, we make this big mistake going into the gravel with the fast chicane, so unfortunately, we can't progress. And so we start the race in P14, which is a bit disappointing for my first ever qualifying session, but hopefully we can come back through the field and get a strong result. Who knows, maybe even a podium, because the Red Bull is a very good car around here. Anyway, let's flick through my setup. Feel free to use this if you want for your own videos or own races or anything. And for my race strategy, I'm running option prime option, which is the recommended one, so I thought I'd just stick with that. As I now go onto the track to start my first ever career mode race. Wish me luck. On the grid now, we see that the two Mercedes is locked out the front row, with Lewis Hamilton on pole. Sebastian Vettel trails them in third place, while I'm starting in my lowly 14th position. And the two Toro Rossos. But hopefully we can make a good race of this, get off to a good start, because the AI are usually very slow the first few corners. So now I switch to the cinematic view to watch the start. Everyone gets a very clean getaway, which is good to see. And we now switch back to onboard, as they're trying to go down the inside of Verne. We slow down behind Jensen Button, and that allows Verne to get back around the outside of us. So that wasn't the most ideal start ever, a bit too cautious. We actually lost a place from the starting position. But everyone breaks early for turn 3. We dive up the inside of everyone, including Magnussen, going up to P8 already. And we get squeezed while Vettel goes very slowly in front of us. So we're almost at the back of him. So from P14 to P8 isn't that bad. And we're thinking about making a move up here, but just can't get it done. Just a bit too far back. Vettel leaves the room though. It looks like Vettel's being held up by Alonso a bit ahead. We might be able to get past Vettel with this right now. We get past Alonso as well. Die down the inside and set in second gear, and we get the job done. Nice clean move there. As we watch a replay of it, dive down the inside, look at the front right a bit, but we get the job done. Now we're close on the back of the Williams as Bottas, who goes very slowly through that corner. We didn't touch him, but he goes out wide, and we get the job done through there. Now onto lap 4, we've got the DRS zone activated. We dive up the inside of Massa. We slightly cut the corner. I think it was just on the curbs actually. I think we're just inside the yellow line. But now we're close on to the back of Raikkonen. We're picking our way up through the field very quickly now. This is for the podium positions. Tried to go up the inside there a bit, but although we left the room, just couldn't get the job done. As we now get in the slipstream, all the back straight, we switch to the cinematic view. We tap the wall and we go around his outside. That's a good move, I say so myself. But Raikkonen behind slows down everyone else for some reason. Oh, the yellow's going very slow through there. So we really got like a 4 or 5 second lead, which is pretty good. And we maintain that lead right up to the first pit stops, as we come in to replace the set of options for a set of primes. Looks like Hamilton ahead also came into the pits, and he was about 5-6 seconds off the road. So hopefully we have the pace to catch him during the stint. It'd be very good if we can catch the Mercedes. But as we come out to the track now, it was a 3.7 second stop, so it's for some reason longer than the last game, which is a bit unusual. We come to the track now in P10. As that's, I think, Kvyat and Hulkenberg got past us. And now Hulkenberg trying to make a move on Kvyat ahead. We go around the outside of Kvyat as well. So Kvyat's getting caught on the inside. We get the job done. Now close in the back of Hulkenberg. He peels off into the pit lane. So don't need to pass him there. Hopefully we didn't lose too much time to Mercedes ahead, as a lot of other people pit, and that promotes us back into P7, P6, P5. Now to the following lap. We're getting good pace. We go purple with 130.6. And now back up to P3 behind two Mercedes. So hopefully we can hunt them down. Coming on to lap 17 now, we've still got about a 6 second gap to Hamilton ahead, so we haven't really caught Mercedes much distant. See, the minimap, we've got quite a few cars up ahead in the cluster. And look at this, we've got both Mercedes in a big pileup, and we're now in first. What the hell? That must have been an incredible stroke of luck there. Alright, let's see what's happening again. I'm going to have a look now at several different angles. Looks like a Caterham took out Rosberg. Hamilton slows down, squeezed through the middle just about. I think there was contact as well. Yeah, we raised a hand. There was a little bit of contact, but we scraped through. But now Hamilton's closing in on us again. As we lose the back end, almost hit the wall there. Hamilton gets past, but then he slows for some reason, which is a bit weird. I don't know why he slowed there. But we managed to stick with Hamilton just about. And we decided to get the undercut on him. So we're going to come into the pits now. I was originally going to put on a set of primes, but I forgot to swap. Forgot to change it, so we're now going on to a set of softs. So we've got to make these last for about 10 laps, which will be pretty hard to do. But let's see if we can do it. Let's have the undercut Hamilton. Where is he? He's coming out of the pits now. Yes, we've just got in front of him. The undercut worked. We've got about a 2 second lead, I believe. So let's hope we can maintain this during our stint. We're now passing quite a few back markers as Kobayashi. We go around the outside of him. I hate it when the AI gets stuck on the apex or corner when you're trying to lap them. It's really annoying. We come around to the end of that lap now. We've got Gutierrez in the Sauber overhead. We go down the inside of him. So that's what the AI meant to do. Meant to stay to the outside of a corner when you lap it. Well, actually, don't get lapped in a corner. That'd be better. Coming to lap 24, we're now going around the outside of Chilton, who does the same thing as Kobayashi. Looking on the replay again, and Chilton actually holds up Hamilton for a few seconds there, which is pretty awesome. But then coming on to lap 29, my tyres are completely over the cliff now. And look at the gap behind. There's only 0.2 of a second, so Hamilton's right there, right in our slipstream. And it's getting closer and closer and closer. This battle for the win isn't over yet. I haven't got this sealed. And look at my tyres. They're brick red, brick orange. You're probably thinking I'll have this in the bag, but then there's a final corner coming up. And the AI are always OP coming out of there. Will I maintain it? I get a horrible, really horrible exit. Sliding all over the place. I have to be very gentle around the final corner. But Hamilton has DRS. He's right behind me. He's coming on the inside. Will I win it? Will I win it? Will I win it? Did I win? Yes! I won the race. God, that was close to the end. Very close. Let's see how close it was. I bet it can't be much in it. Wow, would you look at that? If you look at Hamilton's timing, it is actually no timing. So that means we finished at the same time? That's real bizarre. I've never seen that before. Anyway, please like and subscribe if you liked that video. And comment below if you've ever seen anything like that before. But thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. We'll think Bahrain is the next race. So see you next time, guys. Thumbs out. Take a look past the innocence.
take a step back to yesterday. When life would move slower, we would never grow up. All we knew that love was for when we're older. Anything could happen, secretly imagine. They could never tear us apart, too young to fall. This is our story, that we could take back someday.